We got another fluorescent lamp to fry today. Our victim is a Sylvania F14T12 CW made in Canada in 2000. This came out of my grandparents' place. They have two F14T12 fixtures, original to the house, which was built in like 1948 or 49, which use these lamps, and this one was at end of life. They're preheat fixtures, so you know, it just wouldn't start, it just kept blinking. So I replaced this lamp with my own GE F14T12CW, and I took this one back here with me. You can tell which cathode is the one which is no longer serviceable. This end of the lamp is still serviceable, so when you put this thing on a preheat circuit and remove the starter so it doesn't keep blinking, the lamp will rectify, and it could probably do that for weeks, maybe even months. But we're going to see if we can kill it here today. What I'm going to do is first throw it on my F15 strip light and see if that magnetic rapid start ballast can fry it. If it doesn't before too long, I'll just throw it on the full ham and finish it on that. Alright, let's see what we get. Well, there it goes, it's rectifying. Holy crap, the fixture's drawing 100 watts of power. For some reason, on a preheat ballast, a rectifying lamp doesn't make the ballast draw a lot more current, but on a rapid start ballast it does. It's kind of weird. Yeah, we're using 1.3 amps of current, and the ballast is rated for 0.65. So if I were to let this run too long, which I actually did last night I ran this lamp for a while, and the ballast got so hot that you could hear the tar inside it boiling. Luckily I unplugged it before the thermal protection tripped. This ballast has automatically resetting thermal protection, but yeah, I wish I hadn't have done that, just because it's not a nice thing to do. In fact, if you look down there on the wires, you can see a bit of black there, a tiny bit of tar did leak out, so yeah, I should have been more careful. For some reason, I expected a rectifying lamp to not cause such harm on the ballast. You can look there, you can see the cathode glowing a bit. It has broken since I've started toying around with this lamp. And it looks like it's just going to sit here and rectify. You can see the cathode glowing there. The lamp is strobing quite a bit now. Quite hard on the eyes to look at. Spot on the other end. That end is already very hot to the touch. If you look right there, you can see an interesting kind of a purple glow there. Alright, enough of that crap. It's time to bring out the big guns. Alright, we're all wired up. It's funny, this lamp has never seen an electronic ballast in its life. It's always run on a magnetic preheat system. Now it's going to die on an electronic ballast. Let's plug it in and see what happens. We're running off of just one red wire. Alright, we're on. We got one heck of a glowing cathode. Power draw is 33 watts. Ouch. Looks like it might not actually fry. It's just gonna break from so much heat. The glass is getting so hot. There it goes. Oh, that's weird. The lamp has shifted color. It's more pink color now. Wow. The cathode actually quit glowing. This thing might last longer than I thought. I'm quite impressed. Power draw is 35 watts. Wow. I'm really amazed. Oh, and that is the end. Let's unplug it and see how it looks.
Well, here's what we're left with. This end still looks pretty good, just got that spot there. This end looks very dead. No phosphor blown off this time. It's too bad. Maybe I should have waited for it to cool down. You know, maybe it would have lasted longer. I think it lost vacuum just because the glass got so darn hot. I mean, that's how they always lose vacuum, but usually it happens, you know, because there's absolutely nothing left on the particular end, and you get the orange flames and stuff. This thing, the cathode, just glowed hot enough to melt the glass. We never did get much flames, but regardless, this thing's dead. It's too bad. This end was still really good. What I probably could have done is bought a diode-based rectifier or something and just run this on rectified AC current. It probably would have run for, gosh, I don't know how long. But whatever. It's junk now. Another one bites the dust. Now, the question is, did the full ham survive? Of course it did. There you go. The ballast that can do it all does it again.